Spacewalkers work on a cosmic particle detector, more potential partners to transport payloads to the moon, and a key finding on a Jovian moon. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. On November 22nd, our Andrew Morgan and the European Space Agency's Luca Parmitano were back outside the International Space Station for their second spacewalk in as many weeks, working to repair a cosmic particle detector called the Alpha Magnetic Spectrometer, or AMS. The main focus of this outing was to perform bypass surgery of sorts by accessing, cutting, and labeling the stainless steel tubes that attach the current cooling system to the AMS so that a new system can be attached off to the side of the AMS. This extremely complex series of spacewalks has called for the design, development, and validation of many specialized tools by engineers and astronauts here on Earth. On November 18th, we announced five American companies have been added to the pool of vendors eligible to bid on proposals to provide deliveries to the surface of the moon through the agency's Commercial Lunar Payload Services, or CLPS, initiative. The additions of Blue Origin, Ceres Robotics, Sierra Nevada Corporation, SpaceX, and Tyvek Nano Satellite Systems Incorporated increased the number of contracted CLPS participants to 14. It also further expands NASA's work with U.S. industry to build a strong marketplace for delivery of payloads between Earth and the Moon, in support of our Artemis program's efforts to put the first woman and next man on the Moon by 2024. For more about CLPS, visit nasa.gov/CLPS. There is previous evidence of liquid water under the icy surface of Jupiter's moon Europa that may sometimes erupt as plumes sent into space from huge geysers. But no one has been able to confirm the presence of water in these plumes by directly measuring the water molecule itself. Now, an international research team led out of our Goddard Space Flight Center has detected water vapor for the first time above Europa's surface. This confirmation of water vapor above Europa helps scientists better understand the inner workings of the moon and supports their belief that a liquid water ocean, possibly twice as big as Earth's, is present beneath the moon's miles-thick ice shell. Our Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena, California is developing a robotic explorer that could turn the search for life upside down on icy worlds like Jupiter's moon Europa that are believed to have liquid water below their surfaces. The buoyant rover for under-ice exploration can explore below icy waters by driving on the underside of sea ice and has been tested previously in Alaska and the Arctic. The rover, which carries several science instruments to measure parameters related to life as we know it on Earth, is now on a month-long campaign in Antarctica to test its endurance. NASA's Europa Clipper mission, targeted for launch in 2025, could lay the groundwork for a future mission to search for life beneath the icy surface of Europa. Our aeronautics research in quiet supersonic flight, urban air mobility, electrified aircraft propulsion, advanced air traffic management, and more was in the spotlight during a November 20th flight night event on Capitol Hill. The congressional event featured interactive exhibits and presentations that illustrate how work by NASA supports a key economic sector for the nation and leads to advancements that help make the aviation industry better equipped to safely and efficiently transport passengers and cargo to destinations around the world. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/talk.